Hello everyone, this is Digvijay, Abhay and Prashant, and we are going to elaborate the functioning of wireless charging. Laptop, mobile phones, other electronic devices, all these things need charging, and for the moment we are still using cords and plugs for this. Wireless power transfer isn't new. In the 1890s, Tesla was allegedly able to power light bulbs with no wires and claimed to be able to transmit power from one location to another with no wires. He even extended the range of wireless power transmission to about 48 kilometers. Wireless charging seems so great. I plug this thing in and set the other on it and wow, power. But how does electricity get from the wall into my phone? To make it work relies on simple physics. If you ever wrapped a coil of wire around a nail and attached a battery, then you know the electricity in the battery runs through the wire, creating an electromagnetic field or flux. We all must have done this at home. It's fun and you can use it to pick up paperclip. With the same principle, a coil of wire, magnet, battery, we can make it go the other way too. It's been a magnet in the coil and will generate electricity by taking that magnetic flux and moving it through the coil to create electricity. This is Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction.
The battery creates a stable electromagnet because it's a direct current. It's going one way. The power from our walls is alternating current, changes direction 50 times a second or cycles at 50 Hz. So the electrons are moving back and forth, remember that, because that's the key to charging. Wireless inductive charging gets its name from magnetic field interaction, called induction. Inside of the charging pad and the inductive charging device are tiny coils of wire. The pad being plugged into the wall is fully powered and the power is cycling. When the other coils come with a short distance, their flux will interact with the flux in the device, move the electrons around and charge the battery. If that's the easy, we would think it would be everywhere, but the problem is efficiency. We waste a lot of power filing up for two coils and letting them talk to each other. It's so much better to just plug right in. The future of wireless charging is unclear. It seems that like a great idea, but it's still going to be a short distance system for a while. So thank you guys for watching this.